You talked with investigators there, and are they calling this man in Placerville a suspect in the murder of 8-year-old Layla Fowler?
Well, Colson, they're not officially calling him a suspect, but there are some striking similarities in this case, and they are looking into it, whether there is a connection. They're trying to determine whether there is indeed one. Meanwhile, here at Jenny Lynn Elementary School, you can see all of the people showing up for a vigil that is set to start in about 2 hours from now, a vigil for Layla. The parents of Layla Fowler returned to her elementary school as staff and parents prepared a vigil for the 8-year-old girl.
It's difficult, and I did get to speak with them for a minute today. They seem to be doing, you know, as well as can be expected, and are very thankful for everything the community has done for them.
Investigators, meanwhile, turned over bags of evidence to the State Department of Justice to look for DNA that might reveal who stabbed the girl to death over the weekend. Detectives now say at least two neighbors saw the intruder flee the scene after Fowler's older brother confronted him in the home on Saturday. Investigators haven't yet brought in a sketch artist, but are still considering it. At the Jenny Lind Elementary School, where the third grader attended, parents and grandparents are holding their kids a little tighter.
I didn't know what to tell him yesterday because he didn't want to come to work yesterday, to school yesterday.
And teachers are trying to help the kids cope.
We don't think that anything bad would ever happen to us. And then when something happens, you kind of step back and say, well, we're not a big city, but it could happen here.
The principal said there is still a sense of fear and concern, one that might not ease until Fowler's killer is identified. And you can see the elementary school is decked out in pink and purple ribbons. A lot of people wearing pink and purple as well. Those were the little girl's favorite colors. They're expecting so many people at the vigil tonight. They've actually set up off-site parking at two neighboring churches and are going to provide shuttle service to get here. Colson, Edie.
So, Kevin, now that investigators have that mugshot from the Placer County case, have they shown that to the eyewitnesses, those neighbors who saw the intruder there?
That would be the next step. We haven't heard whether or not they have gone to the three eyewitnesses, the two neighbors, or the older brother and shown them the mugshots. But clearly, that would be the next step in identifying whether or not there is a clear connection in these two cases. Back to you.
Kevin, thank you.